Good evening, everyone. Welcome, a warm welcome to Tea Talks Tuesday. So Tea Talks Tuesday, it's been a great honor and pleasure for me, Mayuri, and Dr. Janaki to see you all on board on this unique knowledge sharing platform. So together we are able to learn, share and educate everyone around us on nutrition, health care and general well-being. And coming back to today's episode, we have an interesting speaker over here. Sujata Stephen is here, ma'am is here. So few lines about her from my side. So she is an inspiring speaker and a nature lover, a travel explorer, adventure and whatnot. Not last but not the least, daddy's girl. Okay, she's here and I'm eagerly waiting for her to listen to her and to learn her success story. So yeah, welcome Sujata ma'am. And over to you, Dr. Janaki ma'am.
Thank you, Mayuri, and welcome, Sujata. Thanks for accepting our invitation and coming on to Tea Talks Tuesday. It is a pleasure for us to have you today. And the topic is very, very interesting. And it is much required for all the dietitians, especially upcoming dietitians. So the topic is skill sets required for a successful hospital dietitian. So what are the skill sets, and all the dietitians, all the students who are here, can ask any question. As long as Sujata is here, she'll be ready to answer. But you should be pleased to answer, all of you. So before we go ahead, let me introduce Sujata Stephen for all of you. Not that she's not known, she's quite popular dietitian around. And she's RD certified practicing nutritionist in Hyderabad with almost 2 decades of experience. She's currently working in Ashoda Hospitals, Malpet. She has worked in various hospitals and she has her own setup, a clinic at home, which is called Nutrilicious. So presently, she's the executive member of IDA, Indian Dietetic Association, Telangana chapter. She strongly believes in active participation of the dietitian in multidisciplinary patient care team, which is very, very, very important. She has put it right. Because most of the dietitians, they dread to go to ICU, dread to go to consultant sometimes, you know. So we have to be part of multidisciplinary patient care setup in the hospitals. So she's the right person to tell us about all these things. And her areas of interest includes PCOS, obesity management, diabetes management, critical care nutrition, etc. She's also presented several health talks in various corporate organizations. She's actively involved in media channels and wrote many columns and articles in various leading newspapers and magazines. She's involved in training interns and fresh graduates. She has presented several papers in national and international conferences. She also won several awards.
Some problem, I guess.
All India Achievers Conference in New Delhi in 2014. And Women Excellence Award on International Women's Day in 2016. This is given by Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Mr. K. Roshayagaru. And the Best Dietitian Award in 2020 Sadhana Awards from Her Excellence Honorable Governor of Telangana, Tamil Sai Sounder Rajan. And she also won Dr. A.P. Abdul Kalam Memorial Excellence Award in 2020. So here is Sujata for us today. The stage is yours, Sujata. Please start.
Yeah. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. It was nice hearing from you because you are my mentor kind. I've learned so much from you and I Thank feel you. Really proud to be part of your Tea Talks today. Thank and you. So today we'll just talk about, I don't want you to bore with all the, what is it, clinical topics like what we usually discuss. So today, I just want everybody to understand the role of dietitian and how we have to present ourselves. Because I've been working in the hospital from the past 20 years, I've seen even I also entered into this hospital dietitian field as a fresher, as a student, and then how we have grown to today, we are able to train a lot of dietitians and we are trying to mentor a lot of students. And this is all only with the experience what we get and then the, how we try to change ourselves. Still, we are like students only. We still learn a lot of things. We still have to understand a lot of things. And we that's how nutrition is should be. And every day, we have to learn a new thing and we have to catch up with the what the advance is going around the world, and we have to update ourselves. That's very important. And because what I understand is the nutrition is the most, very fast growing. And also this is the most trending profession now. So a lot of people are looking into this and trying to get into nutrition profession. A lot of people are opting for nutrition profession. So, and this is the right time that I want everybody to become more successful in this. How to be successful, not just being a dietitian, but how to become a successful dietitian and how to present yourself. That's very important. So can I share the PPT, ma'am? I just have some few points.
Sure, sure. She's a co-host, no? Mayuri?
Yes, doctor, she's a co-host.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, so what I feel is like in India, when you see the nutritional studies were being initiated in 1930s, it's a very early stage as a part of home science. So it has been slowly groomed into like mostly, I think it is still 70s also, it is in the part of home science only. Even now we are part of home science, but gradually it has got a different attention, and in after 60s and currently it has become a new area of practice. Even when we are doing in 19s, I think in 90s when we are doing our nutrition course, that's the time that nutrition has got a different kind of importance, and then people have come out of that home science and they have started putting this nutrition into regular courses like other biology course, chemistry courses and all, and nutrition has become a part of this. So that's how this there was a tremendous change was there from when you see from the starting, and now it has got a very good importance. So this nutrition demand has a tremendous popular nowadays. So what I always feel is this is the fastest growing industry, because nutrition is a part of many other industries. It's not a single kind of industry, because we are part of food industry, we are part of fitness, we are part of other nutraceutical products. There are so many products are there which are being a part of this nutrition. And so the focus is like how all these are mostly comes under this wellness centers, wellness industry. So the main focus is that to provide this essential health services only. So as we see, the number of colleges who are offering nutrition also has been increased in the past decade, and a lot of courses have been come up for the upcoming dietitians and then nutritionists. So the first thing what we have to understand is like when you are taking this nutrition course, Now we have to understand whether we have that skills become a more efficient dietitian, and then what are the skills we need. Though we have taken this course as a dietitian and we have completed the course, but to become a successful dietitian, we have to develop certain skills. So what kind of skills we need to become more successful in this career is like when you see the most important role the dietitian and the nutritionist is to provide the health and then prevention of this all these diseases, like what nowadays people are suffering, like diabetes, hypertension, and all those community kind of diseases. So the main role of the dietitian is to create awareness in the community by promoting good eating habits, good health habits, and then about the lifestyle and all. And also can carry a research and then educational programs, like to help individuals, like in the schools, in the colleges, and in the other communities. So how to reduce the health risk through the nutrition programs, like how to take care of our health and how to prevent all these diseases. This is also a part of our role. And dietitians who are into clinical setup, like registered dietitians, and they have an advanced role, like not only in the community, but also in the hospital sector, like educating the patients and treating the patients, formulating the diets, and all these are the role of the dietitian. So all these have to be, we have gradually developed this only by the time you get into the hospital and start practicing. So these kind of qualities are more needed for a dietitian to be more successful. And then to be a successful nutritionist is to listen to the client's schedule. Like when you are talking to a patient, that understanding the state of mind is so important, because we have to understand that we are in a sick industry, like sick environment. People come with some pain, people come with some problem. So we are not dealing with a normal healthy person. So we have to understand that state of mind of the patient, and we have to listen to them to understand what is that he is expecting from us. So then we can provide them a proper nutrition, and we can give them guidance accordingly. And then examining and then evaluating their eating habits, that is also very important to take their feedback and then understand what is their previous diet schedule, and also how to go ahead and then planning the nutritional activity and including the activity like physical activity and all those things. And it has to be customized. So as a dietitian, we should not just give a diet plan which has been already printed and just passing it on. That will not work out. Okay, we have to customize it according to the patient's need. Then only the patient also will be satisfied, because that diet is being planned discussing with the patient. And then we have to give him that personalized diet program. So I have seen a lot of dietitians who are like, I know they are overburdened these days, but just giving off a diet chart without any personalizing may not be taken so serious, because they also lose that interest on meeting a dietitian, because they think that patients will usually, they come to us and they say, you give that diet chart, madam, we will go and read. So there are the patients who are also with that kind of mindset. So in those conditions, we have to take time, make him understand that when you plan sitting with a dietitian, how it can be personalized to a patient. So that's kind of importance you should create, and then try to spend time with the patient and then give them a proper guidance. And then certain qualities which we need as a dietitian is, first thing is you have to be a compassionate thinker. So you should always be in a what means, like when you are talking to the patient, you should always try to give some time and try to be patient, to listen to them, to understand the problem, and then build a rapport with the patient so that the patient feels more comfortable to come back to you. So, and in those conditions, if you don't give them time or we don't talk to them compassionately, maybe they can choose to another dietitian, or they don't have that feeling of meeting again any dietitian, because they think that these dietitians, they don't listen to us. They just tell what they want. So this is what I also got the feedbacks from the patients when they come to us. They say that they just give the plan, madam. They don't listen to us, what we are going through. So these are the things they come. So we have to be more compassionate. We should listen to them and understand and build a rapport with the patient, so that the patients will come back to you and you will slowly build up a client base, so that you will be referred by the patients itself who come to you. They tell to their own family members, they tell to another person that this lady gives a very good time to us, she makes us understand better. So this is how we have to be. And the next one is the problem solver. Problem solver means like when somebody has some problem in the patients, like in mostly in the critical conditions. So you have to give them efficient solutions. So you should always come with something creative or something innovative kind of solutions, and to solve the problem. So it might be a small problem, or it might be a kind of a critical where you have to take a decision kind of thing. So make sure that you try to understand the problem and give a proper solution to that. See, for example, when a patient comes to your hospital and he says that I'm not happy with the food what you are providing, I'm not able to eat. So I want something else. So what is the something else? So do you have any other options? So try to spend time with him, try to understand what is he looking for, and give him some options and make sure that patient problem is being solved. So if you don't attend, that patient will not keep quiet. He will go to the next level. He will tell to the concerned doctor when he comes. So the same patient will tell to the same problem to others, whoever visit the hospital. So then that at then that problem comes back to a dietitian. They say the dietitian, they have some problem, you go and solve. So if you go and attend that problem will be solved, and try to give a proper decisions or solutions to the patient, so that he will go comfortably from the hospital and they'll be happy with the way you treat the patient. And then comes to listener. So he should be able to listen to the patient. Don't pass judgments. Don't say that you will suffer, you will die, you will not. These kind of things when you say, patients will become more they get more discouraged. They go into depression. They already come with some pain, and because these are the examples why I'm saying these are the comments have been given by the dietitians, and then patients have come to me and they were saying. So recently I met one client, she was there in some hospital. So she's been seen by a dietitian, and then she said to that patient, it seems like no, whatever I wrote in this diet chart, you have to follow. She said, I don't eat onion, garlic. She said, no, you have to eat. And then she left, it seems. So she was so upset. She was saying, how can I eat? I never eat in my life that onion and garlic. And how can I eat that? And this daily is not listening to me. And then she told to her doctor. And then concerned doctor also was, she complained to the doctor that, sir, I won't eat any food from here, because these dietitians are not giving me proper attention. They're not giving me any alteration, like how to change. So these are the things they come up. So patient will not keep quiet, because we have to understand that they are the people who are paying. So they are responsible for each and single paisa they pay to the hospital. And we should be always ready to give them some options. I know you also have some kind of restrictions in the hospital with the vendors or with the menus or whatever it is. But how you are able to convince the patient and spend some time, so that the patient should not feel discomfort in the during the stay in the hospital. So mostly what we have to understand is we should never pass judgments, and we should try to give a proper answer to the patient and try to listen to the patient and also try to convince the patient. If you can convince the patient, patient will never complain back about the same problem. And then flexibility. So flexibility is like in your working hours. So usually the dietitian's work is like 9 to 5. Sometimes you have to come a little early. But I've seen recently girls are coming up and they say when they come for the interview, they say that, madam, I can't work 7 to 4. I can't work late night work. So this kind of things will not work because you have to take a dietitian profession as a serious. You should be ready to work in any kind of conditions, any kind of situations, even it is a lockdown or even it is COVID conditions or in a bund, whatever it is. So you should take your responsibility. Dietitians, because I've seen in this, during this COVID times, a lot of dietitians were sitting at home. They were scared of working in the hospital sector because their parents are not allowed there. So I know this is taking a risk, life risk, but you, being a clinical dietitian, it is a responsibility. If you want to have that passionate and to work as a dietitian, and you need to take up as a challenge, try to work because doctors are working. So clinical professionals, everybody are working. Why dietitians were not coming to hospitals? A lot of patients were like wondering what diet they should be taking. So most of the dietitians are ended up with manpower shortage during this COVID timings only, I'm saying. So that's the reason why that flexibility is also very important. So don't try to fix your timings like 9 to 5 and all, but when you are needed, try to extend your time, extend to give your services. So that's how you can improve your, wherever you're working. So they try to trust on you. You build up such a good rapport with the patients, and also the way you treat the seriousness what you take in that profession will always be appreciated. And then communicator. So communication is also very important. So the work, mostly as a dietitian, it's not a like this job, like you have to talk to the patient. You should always talk to, means you should be communicating with a lot of people, not with the doctors, not only with the patients, but other healthcare professionals who are working with you, like nurses, like other professionals who are working there. So that communication should be very proper. So when you don't have a proper communication in the hospital, you will definitely end up in problems. Because when you don't make them understand what you wanted to tell, definitely there'll be misunderstandings, a lot of misunderstanding comes between the workers, and then you start having a lot of issues which you have to handle them. So that's why the communication has to be very proper, and try to be having that proper communication with the doctors, with the patients, and also build up a good rapport with the other professionals who are working as a team. Because in the hospitals, when you see, it's not a single person job, it has to be a teamwork. So a lot of people attend to the same patient. So it's not about your diet, but other nurses, other physiotherapists, and other professionals also work for that particular patient. So that communication has to be proper, and you have to gradually develop that communication. So I know it is in the initial stages, maybe you are hesitated to talk to other staff and all, but when you start working, you have to be, means you should not keep into a kind of boundaries, not to talk to this and those things. You have to be open up and try to be more open to all the people, and then start communicating with everyone. And then how to ensure your success in your practice is certain things you need to follow. One is networking. So networking is very important, where you have to be a part of a community and build up such a rapport with everyone, not only with the dietitians or not only with your own team members, but you should always have that networking with other professions also, so that you will definitely build up your client base. So community is what we are needed more. So try to give some time in your community. You know, you don't need to go somewhere and do that, but in your own community where you are staying, at least your area people should know that there is a dietitian who can always be available to us to advise or to give time for us to guide us. So that's the importance which you can create in your own community. So that can be effectively done by interacting with other members. So try to communicate and then spend some time, and not only on the nutrition base, but other subjects also. Like you can be a part of other communities, like a lawyer community, or go to another where NGOs are working, and then try to be a part of that and understand their how they work, and then that will definitely give a wide open for you to platform for you to get clients, and you can build up a good rapport with the other community members also. So that's how you have to spend some time for networking. Apart from this community, you also have to be more active in social medias, like use in the social medias, or attend the conferences, workshops, whatever is there, any small gathering is going on, like in the nutrition community also. Try to attend all those nutrition programs which are being conducted, like CMEs and all, by the IDA and all, so that you try to meet other people, and then you will know each other, and you can share a lot of knowledge, and you can also share your any ideas or something like that. So this will give a lot of opportunity to meet a lot of people. So it is a community-based profession. It's not a single person, like just sitting in the hospital will not work. So you have to build that networking, and then you will get a lot of references, and then you can build a good rapport. And then same wise, you can create a professional online presence also. So nowadays, everything is going to be online. So try to present more yourself on online, and create some website or a blog, or do some nice posts in your Insta or Twitter, Facebook. There are so many platforms are there. Use it for your better, to improve your skills or to improve your professional presence in the community. So that you will be understanding what people are looking out from you, so that you can improve yourself. And then good content, if you provide, definitely you will get the great volume of the value of the customers. So good customers will definitely get back to you. So that's how you have to start creating a small page for yourself, and try to put up your thoughts, whatever you're working on. So this will definitely give kind of visibility in the society, and also you will be reaching to a lot of people. And then sharing the knowledge. So this is also very important, that in the industry, when to help and attract more clients, try to share your knowledge, and try to also, you should be able to receive that knowledge, and then keep on meeting a lot of people and attend a lot of other sessions where you can share your knowledge. Okay. And then passion for nutrition is also very important. Unless you are passionate in this job, you will not be able to become more successful in this career. Okay, so passion can lead your nutrition career to hyperactive energy levels, because when you love this job, you'll be more active. You try to be more responsible in your job, and then you try to communicate better, and that successful practitioners can help you to grow yourself in even further, not only in that same hospital where you're working, but also to go beyond that, you need the passion. So then only you can work more effectively, and you enjoy the job. You will not take this as a stressful job, but you will enjoy that job. And then eagerness to learn. So as you know, that nutrition is one of the most dynamic subjects, and also there are a lot of things coming up in this field. So the student attitude is very important. So you should be always have that student attitude to learn so much, because your career, it won't take so much of time before you can call yourself as a successful professional. So you need to learn good the new upcoming, whatever things researchers are going on, and read a lot of journals and understand, so that you will be more yourself, will be more updated with the knowledge. because I've seen a lot of patients these days are coming up with a lot of Google knowledge, you know. So every patient has some kind of knowledge on nutrition. And when you go to patient to do counseling, definitely they will be asking you certain questions. So if you are not aware of those, what are the trending diets or what are the trending practices going on, and all this, if you don't know, definitely they will think that this dietitian is not updated. She is somewhere in the old generation. So that's the reason why you should be always be updating yourself, understand what is the going on in the Google or YouTube or whatever it is, but you should always give a proper advice. So that's how you can stand out in all this. Okay, so that's the reason you should be able to give yourself a better knowledge, and then try to learn what is happening around, and try to update yourself. Okay, and then dressing is also very important. So the wardrobe of a dietitian also, you should dress very pleasantly, and don't try to go with the flashy dresses, and it will distract you, because you're working in a clinical setup, and the presence of yourself, it should be more pleasant, because a dietitian means they expect something like holistic kind of thing, and then they expect something like she's a wellness expert, so we have to learn something. So everybody look at you as a professional. So you, when you don't present yourself pleasantable, definitely they will lose that first impression. Like when you go to a patient, that impression itself may make them listen to you. Okay, so you have to talk to the patient, make him understand. At least 5 minutes you spend with the patient, isn't it? So when you are pleasant and when you are trying to tell them, they'll definitely listen to you and they will follow the guidance what you are giving. Okay, and then patient satisfaction. So nowadays, this patient satisfaction has become a key phase in healthcare. So everybody who are taking feedbacks from the patient, and they are trying to how the patient satisfaction at the end of the hospital, isn't it? Before, this patient feedbacks were not being practiced. But nowadays it has become like even the patient after leaving the hospital, they are giving a feedback. They are leaving a Google feedbacks, or they are giving reviews on hospital, and then each one's performance. Like when you go and talk to the patient, if the patient is satisfied with your diet counseling, definitely he will appreciate you. So this kind of patient, the direct correlation between how patients are treated personally, and also they try to understand how effectively you counsel the patient. So that's why the patient satisfaction is very important. So these days, when you are working in the hospitals, so when you are visiting the patient, understand that every patient is a new patient. Every patient has come with a new problem, and you have to present them with a proper attention. Then only the patient will satisfy. So try to get that more good reviews from the patient, so that your client base will build up and you can become more successful in your career. And then professional means meetings and greetings. Like when you go to a patient, try to introduce yourself. Because I've seen in our hospitals, like a lot of patients, they say that who is dietitian, we don't know. A lot of people has come. So when you don't introduce yourself as a dietitian, patients may not recognize you. So try to introduce warmly and friendly, and try to build a rapport from your first visit, so that patient will definitely try to reciprocate when you start talking to them, and they will understand what you're trying to tell. Okay, and introduce yourself. Always, even though you go with the badges and all, but introduce yourself, tell your name, and then try to communicate with the patients. And then the next one is the teamwork. Teamwork is also very important for a clinical dietitian, because every hospital will not end up with only one dietitian, but they'll definitely have a team of dietitians. So that teamwork is like understanding their roles and priorities. Like everybody has to take the responsibility. It is not only the chief dietitian role, not only that senior dietitian, or not only the particular ward dietitian. It's not that. Everybody should understand their roles and priorities. And one person team, sometimes when you see team members should be encouraged. to provide backup to each other. Like sometimes one dietitian may be overloaded with more patients. So in those conditions, this dietitians have to share that work. So that's how the teamwork will be worked, and the whole department will be appreciated. It's not a single dietitian will not be taken into consideration, but the whole department will be affected if one dietitian is not able to give justice to that particular patient. Okay, so that's the reason why teamwork is very important, and try to support each other. And even though you're being allocated with each different wards, but sometimes if the other dietitian is not able to, then you have to be proactive and try to take that. Okay, so leaders might encourage patients and monitoring, like sometimes excessive case volumes when you have to be sharing that work. Okay, so this is all comes with the team members, that working as a team is very important in the hospital, and you have to be part of the team, and don't try to deviate from that, so that the whole team will get affected. Okay, and then what are the tips? I just want to give a last tips for successful and effective dietitian is, first find a mentor. Like when you are starting your career, try to talk to your professionals, like who are seniors, who are already been in the field, like how they are able to, and you have any doubts, seek their advice, seek their connection, seek their support. So that's how you have to grow in your profession. Okay, so it will not develop so easily. I know it is, it takes time, but initially try to be as a have a mentor, and then try to understand what are the problems you might face and seek the advice of the seniors. Okay, and what are the gaps you can fill? Try to what skills you can put extra in your own field, so that makes you more different. Okay, so some extra skills you have to become a standout in your own area, and look out for areas where you can improve, or why this any problem which is not being able to solve, try to do it in by yourself, and try to make your presence available in that particular areas. And listen what patient says. So listening is understanding of the patient is very important in our profession. Unless you don't listen to the patient, you will not be able to understand the problem, and you will not be able to convince the patient. So definitely the patient will go dissatisfied, and they will give a feedback on you. And keep your documents in order. So documenting is also very important, because see, track of the progress of the patient. Like when a patient visits you, we usually think that we give diet chart and we forget. But the same patient might come back to you after 1 month, and he might tell that last month I have come to you. So you should be able to recollect the patient and try to maintain a record, like how many patients you have been visiting and what problems they have come and what is their progress, and try to follow up with them whenever you have time, follow up with the patient and understand how they are doing. So that makes you more client base will be there, and you can build more patients, and then you can reach to a lot of people. And then your diets also have to be more simple and nutritious, and don't go with these trending diets or whatever the restricted diets, whatever is being there in the Google and all. If you follow that, definitely you will not stand out as a clinical dietitian, because you should always go with a simple, and then try to be more means which the patients can easily follow. And then we have to understand what is the patient's their diet pattern. Based on that, your diet has to be given. Okay, so when it becomes choose, you have to slowly, maybe you're not paid very well, because we have seen a lot of dietitians who are earning a lot of money, and they are doing more like trending in the Google or whatever it is. But those diets, if you are not able to give a proper justification to the patient, then definitely the patient will not be able to follow that, and you will lose the client. So try to stick on to your simple and nutritious diet, which you can make the patient satisfied, so that gradually you will develop that client base. Okay, and then ethics. So you have to always follow that ethics, and always working on ethical guidelines only, Don't deviate yourself. Follow the protocols. Whatever the guidelines is being given, try to follow the protocols and try to implement them effectively so that you will be successful in your future, because you are setting the trend for your next generation also. And then stay up to date. Like as we said, that you have to follow up with a lot of scientific researchers, what is going on, attending the congresses, reading magazines, publications, and then recognitions, what are going on. So all this have to be, you have to keep yourself aware what is going on. Lot of research is going on in the field of nutrition. So every passing day, there are a lot of new promises comes up, and then it will solving the problems is also very important. And then community involvement is very important. So make an effort to be a volunteer and get involved in a lot of nutrition related programs, which the community can be a part of your always daily small community programs, which you can conduct, or going to a school, or attending to any old age homes, or where there are a lot of need for dietitians, not only the patients in the hospital. Your presence has to be there in the community. That's very important. And then choose an area of expertise. Say, like when you're working in a hospital, you can always have a kind of which field you want to be more successful. Like you want to be a pediatric dietitian, you want to be an onco dietitian, you want to be a bariatric dietitian. Like this, there are certain fields. So based on your interest, try to be an expert in particular areas, so that it will. It is difficult for a single profession to get more in multidisciplinary hospitals and dealing with the different hospitals. But we, as a super specialty hospital, we try to handle a lot of patients. But your expertise should be in such particular field. So try to get that expertise in particular field. So that will help you out in future building your profession. Okay. And then interest in food and related fields, to try to understand what is going on in food industry. What are the new products are coming in the market? Try to visit local markets. And because a lot of patients when come to you, they say that particular products we are using. But if you don't know, then they will think that your dietitian is, she don't even aware of what are the products are there. So as a dietitian, you should be going to market, understand what is the new products are coming up, whether what is there in that. So this is all very imminent, very important. And good communication and interaction skills are very important. And you should be having also developed a skill of writing documents, brochures, and writing some articles, and build up that writing skill also. Because as a nutrition proficient, you should be always try to present your knowledge in different platforms, not only in media, not only, you can write your own blogs, you can write your own articles, you can present a lot of articles to newspapers and all. So try to build up, we are not born with that writing skill sometimes, but you can build that gradually by writing small story kind of thing, like small articles on different, and you can present in your own department also. And then aptitude for research. So find out, is there any chances of doing some research? Always try to see if there is any opportunity, try to do some kind of research, because you have a lot of people pouring in the hospital, so you can get a lot of data. So try to present it so that it will be helpful to the future dietitians, and it will be helpful for the society, so that you can present something new. So that is also will be very helpful. And organization skill, like organize, like you should be able to organize your own department, and also you can also provide a lot of, in the hospital, there are a lot of NABH kind of, they'll be conducting in the hospital. So in that conditions, you should be able to have some department organized, well-organized department, like having proper data about your patient visits, having the records. This is all very important also being in a clinical hospital. And then technical skills. Technical skills is like outlook, and then people can trust your knowledge and experience. So when you have the basic knowledge, but you have to present it in a proper way. So that's how you'll be presented as an expert. So that's where you have to use your technical knowledge, like whatever you study, the subject knowledge is what you should have. And that has to be presented properly. Then only people will understand that what you are trying to tell to the people. And this is how we have to understand. And success comes to those who educate themselves. So it will not come so easily, but you should always educate yourself and use it as a weapon to make a name in the market and educate others for creating a healthy nation. So that's what a dietitian has to be. And I hope this will definitely help you out to build a better career and to become a successful dietitian. Thank you.
Wow.
That's
amazing.
Yes. That's a really lot of information. And I'm sure this is... It is like a chapter for upcoming dietitians.
Yes, ma'am.
So
only I just want to put up this because now a lot of people are interested in this field, coming up in this nutrition. So if they come with the better skills, they'll definitely become, because we India need a lot of skilled dietitians, a lot of nutritionists, so that our nation will be better, healthy nation. So even though a lot of people are taking nutrition as a profession, but they're not becoming successful. They're not able to reach a lot of people. They're ending up in small setup or somewhere. So that's because they are lacking of that confidence. Mm. So that confidence will come only when you open up yourself and try to experiment and try to reach to people. And when you build up these skills, definitely you will be successful in this career.
Great. Any questions?
We have one question on Facebook. Samara Aisha is asking. She is asking, ma'am, many clients are very selective of food. They neither have enough fiber through vegetables or the protein source, but tend to gain weight and want to follow a diet, but there are very few options left while planning the diet. Can you please throw some light on this?
Yeah, this is always part of our, when you go to a patient's, so they give less options for us, but you can choose like what is patient comfortable. So in that area, you try to focus, like if the patient is okay with some like cereal grains, or if he's okay with the kind of protein sources and what protein sources we can include. So if he's not taking non-vegetarian, then you can go see what are the vegetarian sources they have. So like that, you have to give them some options so that they'll try to choose in that. So we have to make them understand also sometimes why he's not taking those foods, whether he's allergic to that or whether he's having any other conditions where he has to restrict that particular food items. So based on that, you can justify that, and then you can give patients options so that he will become more comfortable with that.
Any more questions?
Nothing, doctor. No.
Okay. This is quite. You put each and every point that is required by a dietitian to be looked into and practice also, and to gain the confidence. I have one question. How do we maintain dietitians, especially in hospital setting? How do they maintain good rapport with other disciplines, like other doctors? Or because you highlighted that point, are there any tips or techniques or tips for this? One or two tips.
Yes.
How to go about it.
I feel that first thing is a dietitian should always have that positive attitude. So if you have that kind of negative feelings, or you don't have a proper mindset when you enter into the hospital, because a dietitian profession is not that easy, because you have to always be in a positive way, because you are meeting a lot of people with pain, and you itself have some depression, and you are itself are having a lot of issues. You may not give a proper counseling or decision to the patient. So that's why when you have the positive attitude, and when you are meeting people, definitely you try to share that positivity only. So that's how you can your connection with other professions, like you have other multidisciplinary, is that what we work in the hospitals, not just single with the patient or with the nurse, but you have a lot of people in the same profession. So you have to build that rapport with the patient care executives will be there, and then guest relations will be there, nurses will be there, physiotherapist and other. So with all of them, try to have that cordial relation. So keep yourself always smiling and don't be very. So when you don't have that welcoming kind of thing, definitely people will not try to talk to you. Even though they have some issue, they'll think the herself is looking, we are scared of talking to her. Something like that they'll say. So that's why you should always keep yourself pleasant, and you welcome the issues. Like when somebody says that, madam, this patient is complaining that dietitian is not counseled well, you don't fight with them. Instead, fighting with them, you try to correct that issue, you take it in a positive way. If the patient have complained, or because see, in the hospital, definitely you are being monitored by many other people.
Correct.
Okay. So everybody want to see whether is she doing a correct job, or is she really giving a proper guidelines to, because doctors, the consultants are more concerned about their patient. So when they are putting their patient in somebody's hands, like dietitians or in the physio, so whether you are doing justification to that patient or you are misguiding that patient, because consultants or doctors are more concerned about not losing their patient.
Right.
So one patient they lose 100 patients.
Right.
That we should understand. So to gain the confidence from the doctor, you should be able to always be updated by the knowledge what you have to present to the patient, and what are the disease condition you are trying to counsel the patient. You should always have the basic knowledge of that, because now what I've seen, a lot of doctors are staying into dietitians. They are seeking dietitians' advice. Before they don't even need to trust dietitians.
Right.
Now they are asking, madam, can you just tell me about this condition, or I have one problem, is there my patient, I'll send them to you. So they are slowly
building
confidence on the dietitians. So this is the time we should be more confident. We should present in a such a way that they are highly educated, they are well knowledge, they have knowledge of this. So that confidence we should get from the doctors, then doctors will never interfere into your job. So that we have to create. Otherwise, doctor will definitely try to see what diet plan you have given, get the diet chart, what is she, why this she has given this. So everything they will monitor, because they are not confident whether you have given a proper guidance to my patient or not. Because patient will definitely go back to the doctor, he will tell, as sir, I met the dietitian, she did not tell this. Or she told something which I know. So definitely that feedback will go to them. So that's why when you are, every patient is very important. We should not take them so easily.
Yes.
One patient give a bad feedback on a dietitian will definitely stay back for a longer time. So with your learning period, you have to give some time, try to give attention to the patient, and try to educate yourself. Learn. There's nothing wrong in learning. Every day you have to learn. Every patient, when you see a patient, try to understand the disease condition and learn. That's very important.
Very, very true. So you're responsible for not only our actions. Our actions speak. So
yes.
Not only with the doctor, they will show our prescription elsewhere. They keep talking about us. So that's why we need to be abreast of the knowledge, and especially now the patients come with a lot of knowledge. In fact, previously it was not like this. after the Google.
So all thanks to Mother Google.
Mother Google. So they know more than what is required, and they also know the solutions. They also know the names of the medications and what side effects they have. And they also want to know what kind of diet, what is carbohydrate, what is fat, what is minerals or antioxidants, which antioxidant you are giving to tackle this. These kind of questions we are getting nowadays. And I think in a hospital setting, it is even more difficult because more you have to see more number of patients, walk-in patients as well as captured patients in the ICU and in the rooms. So that all, not only another important point I want to highlight is like not only that you counsel the patient, but you also have to counsel the entire family because the entire family will be present and they'll take the decision for the patient. And they are the ones who give a lot of feedback about us, right?
Yes, ma'am. That's very important.
So actually in continuation to this discussion, like when a hospital dietitian and a freelancer nutritionist or dietitian, if you see a freelancer who can give a time, you know, proper time of like 1.5 hours to 2 hours, they sit, they counsel, and I understand the workload with the hospital dietitians, the kind of inflow of the patients they have, and you know how a hospital dietitian can justify this timing, and you know and how they can gain the confidence and build the trust and all these things. How a hospital dietitian, what needs to have? I just want to know how we can compensate that.
24 hours is not enough for them, I would say, because for a hospital of 600 bedded hospital, for example, only a couple of dietitians will be there, or at the max maybe 10 dietitians. Whereas the doctors will be, you know, more in numbers. Maybe doctors may be in hundreds, but dietitians will be only in tens or less than that. So, and the dietitian has to spend more time than the doctor.
True.
So they have a different, their profession is different and our profession is different, not comparable. But definitely dietitian, 24 hours to cover the entire population in the hospital is difficult. It will continue. It's a continuous process.
Yeah, at least for the not the inpatients, for the outpatients who come and you know take the consultation. Definitely, spending 1 hour is, you know, obviously it's slightly more compared to what a general freelancer does, right, doctor? So how a hospital dietitian can mold themselves, or you know how they can justify this?
Yeah, usually in the hospital, every dietitian we have minimum 60 patients to visit.
Yes.
And 60 patients, in that we have different departments will be catered for them. It's like sometimes they have to see surgical patients, medical patients, and ortho patients, cardiac patients like that. So we have to be more organized. That's what I always say, that it will not just happen like randomly if you go. And the timings is very important. So before 11, we have to finish the rounds. So that quick rounds to the patients. So every patient, at least we have to spend at least 3 to 4 minutes for a visit. And then for counseling, we again have to go. So it's like at least in a day, 2 or 3 rounds have to be done to finish that their counseling, or their sometimes some patients will. We have other request also, that patient has some problem, we have to go another attend to that problem. So in that conditions, it may take for 15-20 minutes for us to solve that problem of that particular patient. So and then documenting nowadays, because all the hospitals have gone into this NABH and all these licenses we have to get. So this documenting is also very important. So that's why dietitians have to be very quick. In my hospital only, if the dietitians are slow, I just have to ask them, come on girls, rush, rush. Because they can't just be very slow, spending 1 minute to go to one, they can't finish the rounds. True. So that's why they have to be quick, they have to be fast, and they have to be quick, what do you say, say to the patients also, like the counseling also, it has to be precise and it has to be clear. So if you
clear
one counseling, if you do clearly, they won't ask you 100 times.
Correct.
If you just not clear their doubts and just give the diet chart and come, the same patient will be calling you 100 times and True. Your whole time will go there.
So time management.
So that's why I tell to my dietitians also, if you are doing counseling, do it clearly and ask them again, like, do you have any doubts? Are you okay? Are you satisfied? Or you have anything, call to us. Give their number or take some. So some kind of communication you put them, or else that patient will definitely escalate that, and then again you have to go back to that patient. So that's why that the quick and then action is also very important, dietitians. Not only being you have a lot of knowledge and you yes. are very good in doing counseling, but when you don't reach to all the patients, then it will be difficult.
True.
So that's why that is very important.
Quick action yeah. and time management.
Yes.
Okay. So yes, doctor, we have it on Zoom. Yuvraj is asking, hi ma'am, good evening. Many people nowadays are going to whey proteins instead of the protein rich foods. So is it good? What do you suggest about it?
Yeah, tell me. This is about whey proteins, huh?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So these products, when you are suggesting, see, being a professional dietitian and you are a certified and you are qualified dietitian, and when you are suggesting any proteins or any supplements, see for any clinical studies. Don't go with the brands. Don't go with the product or most of the dietitians have been offered with some kind of incentives also. Or sometimes you have been offered with this, if you promote a product, we will be giving you this. But you will lose the patients and they will lose trust on dietitians. So that's why when you suggest any products, any whey proteins or anything, if you being a registered dietitian or you are a certified, qualified dietitian, then you have to have a proper background of that particular product and whether it is clinically tested and it is being used and what are the clinical studies are there and it is has no side effects, then you can suggest. Otherwise, don't go with the brand and don't go with your incentives. You may earn 1,000 rupees on one product, but you will lose a lot of people and a lot of trust on the dietitians. Okay, so that's what I always say, that you have to suggest the supplements, but that has to have some kind of basic studies on that, whether it is clinically used, whether it has any side effects, or it can be used, or how long it has to be used, and when to use. All these have to be instructions have to be given properly, because if you just suggest a product and if they misuse it again, that will come back to you only. So that
misuse is a very big problem.
Yeah, how much that portion is very important, and how to use, when to use, and these are all things that they look out for the dietitian. They look from the dietitian, like when you are suggesting that. So that is also very important. So usually we suggest a lot of products to the patient, but only when you are confident about the product, you can advise. Otherwise, it's better not to advise any products. Or if they come up with certain products, you can tell them whether it is good or they can go or they should not use. So that kind of things you can always, because that is the reason why I say that dietitians have to update themselves. What are the products in the market and what is coming in the market? And then you should have that market knowledge. And that too, mostly that nutraceutical products are very important. Then only you will be able to advise to your patients.
Okay. This session was another question by some FZ. Okay, there is no name about that person. He or she has finished a master's in the field. In this field, please suggest the career options to pursue in the future.
Yeah, career options is like, see, nutrition, as we said, it is the most fast growing. So it is not, it's a multi industry, like it's not only in the clinical setup. a dietitian can go, reach to the food industry, can reach to nutraceutical products, or they can reach to a fitness world. There are so many options are there. So it depends on in what way you can do justice to that you have to take. So nowadays the people are doing nutrition, but they're not practicing because they're scared of practice. They're not confident of practicing. They say that, no, madam, I'm not, I can't talk to patient, or I cannot explain to patient. These are the things they keep, but they study. But what is the use? So that's why when you take this profession, you have to do justification to that profession. So if you are in the clinical side, try to build up your knowledge in that. Try to extend your skills and develop your that communication. So it will only start when you start doing internship. After finishing your hospital, your course, when you are doing internship, don't waste your time. Just don't time pass in your hospitals, because maybe those dietitians are, they are all overburdened with their duties. They may not give so much of importance to you, but you have to, that period of internship is to learn. So you watch the dietitian, observe the dietitian, observe the patient, how we are dealing. So this will help you when you start your career. So same way when you go into food industry, you are more passionate in cooking, then go into cooking side. You can become more expert in that. You can do a lot of innovative kind of thing, because nowadays cooking is being done by all the household women. And they say they are talking about nutrition. They are talking better about nutrition than our dietitians also. So that's why you being a nutritionist, what you want to be like in the nutrition field, then go in the nutrition field, do something more in that. Or you want to be in the marketing side. There are a lot of opportunities in the marketing side. You can market a lot of nutrition products with your knowledge. You can tell about those products. You can explain to the clients. So these are, this is also, you have a lot of marketing skills, then you go into marketing. If you have more public speaking skills, go as a speaker, go as a trainer, go as a educator to a lot of communities. You can be a nutrition educator, diabetic educator. There are so many educator programs are also there. So you can go as that in that way. So whatever your interest, so you can use your profession, because only nutrition profession has all these opportunities, I think so. Because if a,
only nutrition
software, yeah, software person, he can only do that project. He cannot do multi-projects, he cannot do. The same way, we as other professionals also like that only. They, if a doctor is a gastro doctor, he can only treat gastro patients. But we are more multi-handed, we can treat any patients. We can talk to any patients. We can plan diets to any disease. So that's why this is the most plus point for a dietitian. So you can be any kind of profession, but do justification whatever field you are in that. That's what we say.
Great. Very nice, Sujata.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thanks for giving me this opportunity. Yeah, excellent presentation. It's like, you know, sky is not the limit for nutritionists or dietitians.
Yeah.
Any more questions?
One last question, Dr. Samta is asking, what are the career options for someone who has finished the postgraduate diploma in nutrition? Can they be a dietitian?
Just now she mentioned about all these things.
Yeah.
it's about all about passion, in which area you are interested.
Yeah.
You can take that.
That's all. So it may be a bachelor degree or it may be a diploma degree. But if you have do it in a proper way, means you are doing it in a from certified universities or well-known universities, all from a proper disciplinary courses, if you do, definitely you can achieve, you can do further things later on, but at least basic knowledge you'll have. But nowadays the certifications have become more easily available, just you can pay and get the certificates. Those people, they can, if they work, definitely they will not do the justification, and they do a lot of damage to the profession. So that's why I always urge to people who don't do for certifications, don't practice for certifications. If you are interested, get knowledge and better you improve your knowledge, you better your skill, and then you try to become a professional dietitian rather than just a certificate holder dietitian.
Any more?
Any online internships available for students?
Yeah, there are a lot of online internships are going on. So
can connect to Sujata?
Yes.
On Facebook.
Yes, sure.
Anybody who's interested can connect to Sujata on Facebook.
Yeah.
And check on the internships available, because she's connected to a multidisciplinary hospital, which is a well-known hospital. It will be an ideal place for you guys to understand all different kind of patients. You can see different kind of patients.
They are asking like knowledgeable session and all. I was just concerned about the clinical side. Please put some light on the hiring process and interview questions for hospitals hiring.
That's a different session now altogether.
That's true.
Sujata, she did a lot of justice by putting all the points. Now,
yeah.
If you ask Sujata only, she can take one class for each point. That much of depth and intensity is there in each and every sentence.
Yeah, definitely.
So I think we'll definitely run a series of this, you know, career options.
People who are serious in taking up, definitely we are there to guide you, or we try to train you, because we want all the dietitians to be more successful and we want you to see in a better places, rather than people who are not having certifications. They are more success in the nutrition career and they've been called as a renowned popular celebrity dietitians and all. So we want all of you to become a celebrity dietitian. So that, see, it's all that everybody have to put their passion and try to put your 100%, definitely you will become. So main thing what we always say is the nutrition is a wellness kind of industry. So present yourself properly and dress up yourself and try to groom yourself and try to have a proper body language. That's very important. That positive body attitude should be better. And all this will, nowadays, the most of the hospitals are looking out for a very pleasant personalities, or who are having a good communication. And all these are very important. So dietitian is not just being getting a certification. People are not looking for the certification. They are seeing who can present themselves, who can convince patients. Put yourself more pleasantable and try to groom yourself. That personal grooming is very important. And your communication, the way you talk to patients. So all this will be seen in hiring you. When you go for interview, the confidence levels you present is what they see. So if you are more confident, definitely they will take. If you are, when you can't talk to one person in the interview panel, how can you talk to a patients who are, you are meeting them randomly, isn't it? So that's what they usually see. So that's why a dietitian should always have, the best thing is build up that communication. Try to become more, expressing is very important. You should be more expressive, more presentable, and everything is what we usually need. So not just certificate. You are qualified, no doubt in that. But when you're working, all these are very important. Your interpersonal skills, your technical skills, your soft skills, all this will take you to next level, or else you will end up. You will be there in the hospital working from the same hospital for 20 years, just you are a dietitian over there. And nobody in the world knows about you. So you have to reach people, try to reach to a lot of other areas also, and try to build up your own client base.
Well said. In the very beginning, you have highlighted one point to let your own community know that there is a dietitian here around to reach. That's very, very important. If all the dietitians can let the community know that they are there present for their, to reach them and to take guidance, then I think it will be a good, people will be benefited, and even dietitians also will be benefited, and they'll get some recognition. I feel being dietitian itself is a celebrity status.
You are responsible as a communication, means in a community. A dietitian course is not for your earning money. It has to be come service. With that service motto. You have to give your time for the community. Then only you are doing justification for being a nutritionist. It's not like you want to become a more popular, then you will end up with only kind of very few patients. But you have to reach a lot of people. Then you have to reach to community, reach to people. Because you see, you're in a country where there is a lot of need for this nutrition. If you are in somewhere in a Western country where you can only see per day one patient and you can end up here, it's not like that. Here, dietitians are, when you go to government hospital, they see hundreds of people, they need diet counseling, but dietitians are not available. So a lot of people go to their home without any diet advice after getting a very critical operations. Critically, they have been sick. They are in ICU conditions, but no dietary advice. Nobody is giving them any diet advice. So there are a lot of people are going with that. So that's the reason why at least now our India has to get a dietitians who can reach to at least now. What I heard is we have like one dietitian for 50,000 people.
Oh my God!
So that is the ratio we are now. So I don't know when this one dietitian will reach to 50,000 people also. So that's why we have to have more dietitians and more active dietitians, not the passive dietitians, but active dietitians who can reach to the community.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Sujata, for sparing your time and coming over. And you are getting hearts and you are getting thumbs up,
claps.
Yeah,
thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. Actually, my mentor is like when I started, Janaki ma'am, I was just admiring her. I never used to meet her. Like when I was as a student or when I was studying, I was just looking out for people who are success in this career. I could not find anyone who was success, because even that is the time where nutrition is just people are coming up. And by the time I came, who are the successful means? I've seen Janaki ma'am in the paper. Then I thought I should become like her. But I always take her guidance and I always take her as inspiration. And today, whatever I am is like because I've seen Janaki ma'am, Janaki Srina. Oh,
you are giving me goosebumps.
Those are the facts, doctor.
I love
this. That's what I'm saying. No, we should have one mentor. Though yes. I met her after many years I met her, but she was there in my mind from long time. So that's how I was like trying to follow her tips or follow the way she dresses, the way she presents herself. So all this will be when you like that passion, when you like this profession. And you will definitely have one people where you try to get that inspiration. So that's how we should always have one mentor kind of person where you can get some motivation. No? So that's how I always feel.
And you, both of us are in the same college. She's a junior in MSc.
No? Yes. Oh.
Yeah. I think 2-3 years a difference is there for us. I mean, I'm not in age. I mean, I'm much older, but in studies.
But you don't look like ma'am.
Photogenic. Okay. So we had a good time in college also. That's we were, I mean, kind of, I would say I'm a bit rebel in college.
Yeah.
If my persons are listening, they will know it.
So that's all. Another thing what I want to say is, dietitian not just be in this field, but try to have other passions also. Like you can be a model, you can get into another fields, like whatever you are interested. So try to develop that interest. Means that creativeness will definitely help you to become a more matured person, and you will learn a lot of things. So not that being seen, as Janaki ma'am, she do a lot of paintings also. So like that, I started doing some gardening kind of stuff. So there are so many things which we also have. It should be, you have to develop a kind of passion in whatever you are lacking to. Not that you, because you're a dietitian, you have to stick to hospital. It is not like that. So all this will help you out, because you are a community person. You are a person who have to be, people look at you. So dietitians are means it's not a desk job like or something. They look at you and they want to learn from you. So try to be more active, more creative, more passionate, more fashionable, more stylish. So all this will help you as a profession.
Great, great. Super. In fact, I was toying with this idea, Mayuri.
Yes,
we
yes.
Should, showcase the other side of the
dietitians.
In tea talks.
Yeah, we'll do
that
it.
That will build up a lot of bonding between us.
Yes,
very true.
We should do that. Maybe we can start next month, National Nutrition
Week. Yeah. We can start, definitely. We'll work on that, doctor. That's why the few lines were in the initial, I've given that nature lover, traveler, explorer, everything. Jeez.
Okay.
It was a great session. It was a great session, Sujata ma'am. We enjoyed it a lot, and it a lot of information and very inspiring words from you. I hope all the listeners would have got some inspiration for you. And we will definitely plan a series of this, and we would be inviting you once again.
Definitely.
Many times.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you for inviting me, and it was my pleasure being part of this and then sharing knowledge. And it is a very good platform, and it is going very successful. So though it has started in a lockdown time, I think so, but it has become a more knowledge sharing platform nowadays, and a lot of students are getting benefited out of this. So I should congratulate Mayuri and Janaki ma'am for taking all the efforts and creating this platform. It's a very cute platform. Like Tea Talks is a very easy kind of thing where people can log in to understand what's going on in nutrition. That's what I've seen. Your topics are also very closely related to practicing dietitians, and you are getting a lot of people from different areas into this platform. So that's very important, like not boring kind of stuff, but you are getting creating very attractive sessions. So maybe coming up, we expect more like that. And thanks once again for
the responsibility is increasing now.
True.
So good work from all of you will increase our responsibility.
Our expectations are also increasing.
Soaring up, yeah.
Definitely, we'll try to keep up your expectations.
Good. Very nice. This session left us with a nice feel-good factor. Thank you so much.
Thank you all. See you next Tuesday, same time, same place. Bye for today.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Bye.